for another round of Standard with Jund. Sand is okay. I think I'm gonna keep a little heavy on the lands, but we do have a scry land. And Dead Protector, so there's a lot of good draws we could have. I guess Red Green Devotion again. So I don't think this matchup is too great, but it's definitely not winnable. This game is going pretty badly. Pretty sure I just need to kill a Zengos. Zengos is definitely the best card against our draw, too. So, I think we're going to lose this one very easily. Tasker is good. I can get three cards in my graveyard if I go Wooded Foothills, Hero's Downfall. So, can't quite cast two spells in one turn, but I guess it'll be good for next turn. Maybe we're going to go to four. Again, I just have to kill this Zengos. I would have been in much better shape if I just cast this Dead Protector on turn 2, but I certainly didn't think the game was going to play out like this. Yeah. There's certainly no way we can win at this point. Here. You're gonna take two creatures. I play Tasker. Play Wooded Foothills, fetch, use Kolaghan's command, and play Tasker. But we'd be at three. Should be worse than that because I'd have to take one for the fetch. So yes, I go to three. And then I get a mountain. But I would still need to pay one for. Make red, black, black, red, so I'd go to two and kill that, block that, and we'd still be dead. So I'm just gonna cast Gather the Pack. I don't think we have any outs. I missed again. Well, so far I have not been too impressed with this card, but I think I've cast it four times and hit zero creatures three times. With the ultimate price and the crux. And I think that's it. That last guy had Reclamation Sages. This guy, I guess I don't know that he doesn't, but I'm assuming most people don't, so I'm gonna leave in a couple coursers. I mean, I guess most people have like probably one sage in the board room, but they don't also have Woodland Bellowers. Great in this matchup either. Sounds great. Don't have a second black source again, but hopefully that'll be fixed by the time it matters. I'm torn between using my mana efficiently to cast this Gather the Pack and just Thoughtseizing. So I'm going to Thoughtseize. It also lets us save our Gather until we might have Spell Mastery later. I'm going to take his only real spell. Course was also good, but I can just wrap that away. As long as he doesn't draw too many cards off of it or whatever. Surprised he played that. I wonder if he drew, if that means he drew a 4-drop, or a 5-drop rather. I'm surprised he didn't just play Courser there. That makes me want to Kolaghan's Command him. I'm going to do that. Ugh, that's really awkward. I didn't think about that. To Kolaghan's Command, I might have to get a mountain, which means I can't cast Courser next turn. So I think I'm actually just going to get a forest and cast Courser. I can't afford to miss my land drop next turn. Also, it's not guaranteed that he drew a 5-drop. He could just be playing it in case he drew a 5-drop or whatever. But I guess that's probably the better play, because that way if he doesn't draw a 5-drop, it's much better for him to play it the way he did, and there's not that much downside, honestly. I really just want to cast this Wrath of God, so... Is that anything else on top? Yeah, I'm just going to cast... Let's gather the pack and hope there's a land on top. Leave a forest in case we hit like Sylvan Wayfinder. Jeez, this card is just. It's not a winner. I hit a land at least. We need another one, but we still don't have double black. There's not a black land in our graveyard to return with this guy either, so. As awkward as it is, I'm gonna have to put this land on the bottom, I think. It would let me. Play and flip up a Den Protector, which is reasonable, but I really just need to hit a land that casts Curse of Fate and Whip. Another Den Protector, okay. Zenigoth. So otherwise, that's about it. I mean, he has one unknown in hand. There's one draw stuff we didn't see, but otherwise, the only relevant card he has in hand is Zenigoth. So yeah, there's that. On a good note, this will carry to cast our spells. No creatures in our graveyard to return with Kolaghan's Command. His hand is pretty bad. There's a lot of blanks. I don't really want to make him discard a card. And the 2 damage doesn't really do much. So I think I just want him more of Den Protector. I guess this way I can flip up Den Protector next turn if I need to, because I want to kill the Zenigoth before Wrath. So this way I'll be able to flip up Den Protector, rebuy whatever it may be, and kill Zenigoth, and then play the Sylvan Caryatid so the next turn we can Wrath. Another Zenigoth. I guess when I flip this up, I could get like ultimate price maybe. So here's downfall, I guess, which would kill Zenigoth. But I have another Den Protector to attack Zenigoth. So I kind of want to get cut, so that way I can, you know, for one mana kill whatever he plays next. So I can, like, if I'm quite a pipe dream to be able to whip and then cast another black spell, but, you know, whatever it may be. So unfortunately, I'm going to have to wrath away my carry to that I'm using to cast it, so I'm going to need to hit another black spell if I want to cast another double black card, or another black land, rather. Okay, so that was his card that we didn't know about. Tossing. Even another card we didn't know about. Maybe there was two draw steps. I could have swore there was only one, but... Ugin. Okay, that's really annoying, because you can kill my Dem Protector. I guess there's two draw steps we didn't know about. I thought there was only one, but... Okay, I'm drawing a Downfall. I'll kill Ugin, I guess. Cost to activate 11, so you can do that and make my life total 1. Jeez, I didn't even think about that. Probably, I might just be dead then. He used to have 8 power total. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So he doesn't even need to activate his Xenagos to get there. And then he needs 9 mana, so he can plus Xenagos. I guess I'm just dead if he knows, if he realizes that. I'm assuming he does. But not much I can do, so. Beat this Atarka. I guess he's fetching. Okay. Okay, it's plusing Xenagos, so I'm guessing he knows that he can just formidable or activate this guy. Yeah, that's 11 mana. We go to 2 and he pluses out, I guess. Yeah. Alright, well, the deck's okay. I think it's a little weak to Green Red Devotion. The mana seems really awkward, but that might just have been a function of me not really drawing Satyr Wayfinder too much. Especially after, like, you know, I cast so many Gather the Packs that just whiffed. Where if those had been hitting, like, Satyr Wayfinders, I might have been okay. But, yeah, the deck's okay. I think it might just be a worse absent, though. But anyways, thanks for watching this week. I'll talk to you later.